AS is a form of inflammatory arthritis, affects about 1 in 200 people, and it affects younger people. Ankylosing spondylitis affects the joints of the spine and also the joints where the spine joins onto the pelvis. If it's not adequately treated, it can lead to significant disability. So how do we treat ankylosing spondylitis? We tend to advise both a drug treatment and non-drug treatment. So the non-drug treatment comprises a regular exercise program, physiotherapy, stretching. The drug treatments usually start with anti-inflammatory medications, such as ibuprofen. But if that doesn't work and the pain and stiffness are significant, we would tend to offer patients a treatment with what we call biological therapies. These are quite strong drugs. Usually you have to inject them yourself. They work for a good number of people. They can have side effects and they're expensive. And unfortunately, they're not a cure. So as soon as you stop them, the pain and inflammation almost always comes back. ATAP stands for the Arthritis Therapy Acceleration Program. This involves a close collaboration between scientists and researchers in Oxford and Birmingham, together with 7 NHS trusts in total. Collectively, we're looking into the underlying causes of these inflammatory diseases, and we're hoping to bring new treatments to patients as quickly as possible so that they can benefit from them. One of the key objectives of the ATAP is to actually match up the right treatment for the right patient. This may involve doing what's called experimental medicine, where we combine giving new treatments with a detailed study of people's immune systems to work out which is the best treatment for them. Now, we've already used the ATAP program to see if a new drug called namilumab works for ankylosing spondylitis. We're now completing what's called a phase 2 trial.
I think there are a few reasons that I decided to do the trial. The first one was that I wanted to alleviate the pain, and I thought that the trial would be a really good way to do that. The second was that I'd been in pain for a few years and knew that lots of other people had this disease as well. So I wanted to play a part in the active sort of research and finding out for new treatments. Every 2 weeks, I needed to come to the Nuffield Orthopaedic Centre. I came for a total of 12 weeks, a 4-hour commitment for each time that I came. Absolutely worth giving up the time, and I still feel the positive benefits sort of now, which is over 2 years later.
Well, people do often get quite a lot out of taking part in a clinical trial. You get very detailed attention from your research nurses and research doctors. You also have the opportunity to help develop treatments which could potentially help thousands, tens of thousands of people in the future.